My name is Ilan Sinelnikov, and I'm the president of Students Supporting Israel National.
Oh boy, where are you based?
We're based in Minneapolis, Minnesota, but we work with students on over 40 campuses across the country at the moment.
What has the experience been of SSI here on UCLA campus?
Well, it was not an easy road, that's for sure, and especially last spring semester. I'm not sure if you're aware, we hosted an event in which our flags were ripped from the walls of the event.
Flags?
And our flags from the event, and the speakers were disrupted and everything was shut down. And it was all led by SJP that tried to come and intimidate us. And I'm happy that a few months later, we managed to get into the main SJP event on their main stage and show them our message as well. So if they got us at a smaller event on one campus, we got them on their national conference.
What did you do once you were in the room?
So once we were in the room, I took a few pictures of what is going on over there. At first, it was a lot of dancing of all the SJP members. And then they sat down, started to get seated in order to begin their program. And as soon as most of them sat down, my friend Rudy and I, that we work both work together, Rudy started walking from one side of the stage, I started walking from the other side of the stage. We got on the stage with their messaging. I carried the Israel flag in my pocket. As soon as we got into the stage, I took it out of the pocket, and we were right there in their main center. I'm with the flag.
How big is the flag?
The flag? Not small.
So you're on the stage with this flag, the Israeli flag?
With this flag, not a small flag.
So
that's a good size.
Was there someone speaking at the time? Was there a?
They were about to begin their program. They were about to begin their program, and their main announcer was about to start.
When what did you say on the stage?
So personally, when I was on the stage, I heard that inside all of them were screaming "Intifada, Intifada" many times. I'm Israeli. I grew up in Israel during the Second Intifada. And between 2001 and 2003, I know what the Intifada was, which most of those kids have no idea what it was.
Weren't there over 1,000 Israelis slain during the Intifada?
Over 1,000 Israelis were killed. My childhood definitely was not normal, I would say. And when we were on the stage, I screamed them, none of you even knows what Intifada is. You're calling for the murdering of Jews, and I am here because we're not going anywhere, and Israel not going anywhere. And your Intifada did not succeed back then. It will never succeed anymore in the future either. So those were some of our words up there.
What kind of reaction did you get from the crowd?
I think they were shocked. I think they were really shocked. I think they didn't expect that their security could have been a little bit better. But they started at first, they started booing. Later on, they said, we're going to call the security. The security came, and I said, you got to leave. But I said, without police officer, they're going to tell me, you need to leave. We're not going anywhere. So the police officers came, and as soon as the police officers told us that we need to walk away, then we walked away.
Did the crowd try to get violent or hostile with you?
Well, they got pretty close here. A few of them got on the stage, got very close and, like, touched me right here. And he's like, get out right now. And I told him, like, don't touch me. I'm not going anywhere. Bring the police, then we'll walk away. I actually very thankful for the police because I know that inside of this room, some of the sessions that they run, it's sessions that compare American police brutality to what is going on in Israel, that our police forces train together. So the police officer that walked us away and treated us very well, and I'm thankful for LAPD that took good care of us and also does their job in the best side possible. Just like we were ready here with students supporting Israel, just like we were ready on 40 campuses across the country, it's always what we do and not what they do.
Anything else you'd like to mention?
No, I just believe that the pro-Israel students should be brave, and they should never be afraid of representing their country, representing their identity, and be proud. And if SJP shuts down our events, we don't need to go there and scream and start freaking out like SJP does, but we will go into their main event and show our message 10 times as strong.